Hair trouble. Hello. Is there anybody there? I can never get the angle right on this thing. I can only apologise. Trying desperately not to knock things over. I'm quite close. I will move a little further back so you can actually see. Just the one jug, not two. I thought I could have themed it jugs had I bought two of the things. I thought this was a bit crazy. It's very crazy. I don't often buy ceramics and they tend to end up on my shelf for research rather than necessarily getting sold. But it was just so crazy. There's no signature on it. But I quite liked it. I thought it was very odd, very strange. It just had a nice quality about it. Glazed inside, mad colours, very 1980s, very stylized. Hello, Lex. Hello. Sam? Reselling Polly. Sam. God, yes. That's... Sam? Reselling Polly. Sam. God, yes. That's really bad. Of course I know you're Sam. So sorry. Hello, hello, hello. I'm going to see if I can actually put some chat up over here. It doesn't always work. You always get me without makeup because I've just done... Julie, hello. Stee, hello. Our favourite Stee. Saw your... I caught up on your haul from the weekend. I know you're having some trouble with sales and I've had some pretty... I think we've all had some really strangely shitty days. I've had some good days, surprising sales, and then some absolutely shit ones. So, Oh dear, yeah. You can always get me without makeup because I've come back from yoga, you see. I've come back from doing what I need to do. Stretching myself, indeed, so I don't seize up, because that happens at a certain age. Most of you won't know. Peter, hello, Peter. Oh, everybody's in. Well, what time is it? Oh, well, I suppose, yes, you're supposed to be working because it's the afternoon now. Shelster, hello. How are you? How's it all hanging? I thought I'm sitting here with my boots on. I really haven't prepared in any way, shape or form. I may have to move you back a bit because you're not going to be able to see the goodies, by which I don't mean you. Oh, there's these strange little... My husband makes these funny little planes. They're very delicate and I'm just moving them, hopefully without breaking them. The cat stood on one the other day. It must have been that one. I'm sure that's not supposed to happen. Fizzy Vimto. Sweet. Very sweet. It's been terribly up and down, hasn't it? Look, I haven't got a white stripe. I took care of business and got rid of my white stripe. I keep threatening to become to kind of Heather the White instead of Heather the Brown. But unfortunately, there's not enough white to do it yet. I'll have to wait a few more years, I think. But every time I get a certain amount of... You won't be interested in this, youngsters. But every time I get a certain amount of like white hair come through, which looks like a bird, a sort of roily shat right on the top of my head, I think, you know what? I could just go white haired and be one of those mad ladies with white hair, as opposed to a mad lady with brown hair. Oh, you had a rant. Oh, good. You've got a new iPhone. Brilliant, Shelster. I hope that works out. Sibley-licious. Sibley-licious. God, I won't be able to say that after a drink or two. you're interested. Well, yeah, when your hair's as dark as mine, and this is pretty much my natural colour, although none of it is natural anymore. I want white hair. And I keep watching these ladies on YouTube who do it. But you see, when I go white, I'm going to have to be a professional wearer of hats for about 2 years because I don't want short hair. I want long, mad white hair. So I'm going to look into it. But it's going to be a few years yet. But when I do it, I want to do it and have fun with it. Because why not? But I will be the white as opposed to the grey. My father has completely white hair, absolutely, utterly white hair. But then he's got amazing blue eyes and it works. I just look kind of ill if I'm grey. I mean, I'm wearing grey now, actually. It doesn't do a whole great deal for my skin tone. Oh, let's put those away, shall we? Haven't got the nipple covers yet. anyway. white hair rules. It certainly does. Now, Shelster will know all about this. Cashmere. For £2? Thank you very much. I like this. This particular shop I go into is run by lots of wobbly old ladies. Bless them. Purple. Ooh. Yeah. doesn't it fade? It fades, and it's difficult to get it, the hair, to hold onto a strong colour, so I gather. Obviously, I'm not much of an expert. But I think getting this out will be quite fun. I might have to go to a proper hairdresser instead of doing things myself, because I don't want it all to just drop off my head or melt or whatever. Nasty things that can happen with hair. So I was loving this cashmere. It's V-neck rather than roll neck. I think we all know that right now roll necks are probably, seem to be the flavour of the week. And it's that kind of sort of limey green thing. Oh, colour just falls out of your hair. Yeah, mine doesn't like to take it very much either. But I don't want my hair to fall out. I think that's probably my major worry. I think this is a 3/4 sleeve, actually. But I have looked it over quite carefully. I spend quite a lot of time in this charity shop because they have all sorts of stuff hidden amongst the rails, and it's worthwhile looking things up. And I've got some good brands today. I'm a very happy treasure pirate, because one of my ladies who I get stuff from at my flea market, her source, if you like, is dried up. So last week when I went, she didn't have very much, and I bought a few things almost to be kind, because she's really sweet and she works really hard, and obviously she's trying to get new sources, and I need to keep her on side. I will have to, but I don't want to be that sort of yellowy orange, because me blonde would be a very sad thing. It was bleached to take the red in the summer. It dries a badger's arse now. That is dry. That is dry. So I hope you approve of my cashmere pochasse shellstraw, because I rather like that. Actually, that wasn't the only bit of shellstraw I got. Green. It depends on the shade, though, doesn't it? There's a lot of people where I live who have some very interesting colour hair. And I always did contemplate doing that pagan red thing. I call it pagan red because so many of my dearest friends are obviously deeply pagan and have that very red hair. And I, although I'm tempted because it would probably suit me, I don't want to look like everybody else. So, and I think green, I just like the Wicked Witch of the North, really. Could be fun. Or that I'd just blow my nose over my hair, one or the other. Sorry, that was revolting, wasn't it? What's the total pain? Lobster, they're a total pain. Oh, I'm sorry, I've missed one. But funny. I like things that are funny. Now, half of this stuff, it was amazing. Some people can carry bright colours and amazing colours, not so much me. A lot of the stuff in this shop was £2, and this was no exception. Hanging there on the men's rack. It smells a bit perfumey. I'm thinking it might have been a lady's. But of course, when you're looking, you notice things like leather, thingies on the toggles. There's a technical term. Thingies on the toggles. Oh, God. There is a little grubbiness here, which I'll attack with aforementioned baby wipes. The one with kids. Because it's a sort of pale colour in it, but it's a nice quality thing. And the brand, which I did look up in the shop, because I know they make riding boots, but I had no idea they made jackets. Let me try and, I don't know if it comes up back to front, you know, I'm hopeless with this kind of technology, is Aigle, A-I-G-L-E. And I did look briefly up on comps, and they go for over £30. In fact, more like 50, some of them. So if I can clean it up and check its pockets is for valuables, as I saw Pound Girls live this morning, where she found a nice pair of 9-carat gold. You're working on me, Adamant. You need more glue. And it's too cold to leave the house. Don't leave the house if it's that cold. You're in Wales. It's cold and probably wet, I'm guessing. It's cold here, but we're not wet yet. but no, don't leave the house on my account, please. It can wait. Although I'm quite excited. I must admit, when the postman comes to the door, I'm like, ooh, I wonder. So I'm getting into a state of excitement. What I may do is kind of just put them under the Christmas tree and save them. Yeah, there you are, Pango. Hiya. That was brilliant. And it just goes to show, check, check, check pockets is. Half the time you just find a scrunched up, used up tissue. But you might find gold. And that was absolutely brilliant. I was so pleased for you. Because that's a lovely little bonus that you just don't expect. Mind you, I bet whoever gave that stuff to the charity shop or wherever is going around going, I had a pair of gold hoops, I wonder where I put those. But there we go. Wet, always wet. Yes, always wet. So there we go. A rather dull thing, but actually there's quite good money in that. Aigle. Who knew? Some rice eyes yesterday. What's a rice eyes? Rice eyes. Maybe there's a typo there, or maybe I'm just ignorant because I don't know what my size are. Excuse me. I go to yoga, get myself all kind of stretched out, and then come back and cough up a lung. It's not good. So, yeah, £31 odd spent here. Wow. Okay. A vintage yellow case bought in Bristol. Roll girl watch strap. Isn't, yeah, always worth going through the pocketsies. So that was £2, that jacket. Here's a nice vintage item. My jackets are starting... Stop chewing my own hair, would be good. My jackets are all starting to sell now. I'm starting to sell suits and jackets. And this one is quite an interesting style. It's got done up three pockets. Hello, Lisa. Hiya. Nice to see you. This has that definite charity shop smell to it. Not hideously unpleasant, just its own little aroma. So this was stylish. It should sell. It's actually a short, I think, but it's vintage. It is vintage. And I did see. Oh, Dunn & Co. It's not an amazing brand, but I thought it was more the style. A lot of charity shops ask a lot of money when they see a jacket that's in this kind of styly. I wonder why they have buttons on the pockets. Maybe they're frightened all their cash would pee out. No, there's no pee-pee. I don't buy things that... And I don't go sniffing everything, but believe you me, if it's not smelling good, I ain't buying. So that was £2. I don't know what I'll get for that. I'll do a bit of research, because that sort of button-down pocket thing is a little bit unusual. Look at my Brighton wallpaper again. Yeah, let's see if I can come up a little bit. Hang on. Excuse me. No, I thought it did that. Oh, maybe that's the size the chair goes. See, Steve, they don't make them big enough for us tall people. Oh, excuse me. Bear with me. Oh, now I think golden metallics are in. Chinese food. Chinese food. Well, a little bit of Chinese food. I think golden metallics are in again this year. I keep seeing. So I picked this up because it's a little gold dress. Sorry, Steve. We're on to clothes. I can only apologise. There we go. Oh, here it is. There we are, a little dress. Unusual design feature. It has little beads around here, but it wasn't missing any. I had time to check. Now, I didn't know the brand, and I didn't even bother looking it up, because for £2, I thought, I know I'm going to get decent money out of it. And I still can't really read it. Project D by... Oh, it's in sort of script, and I can't be doing this. Dunnock and Thistle, is it? No, something in Tabitha. I'm going to have to do a bit of research on this. I mean, I think even if I hold it really, really close, it's not really going to want to focus. Oh, look at this. How is this for professional? I'm showing you a bunch of blurriness. That's... Oh, dear God. In fact, I've just realised that there probably was a little slip layer that you could put under there, but people can always put their own. It's got those funny little buttons there. So I'm imagining there was an underlayer at some point, but it's not the sort of dress that desperately needs lining. I mean, it's got its own lining. Maybe that's so you can actually attach it to your bra straps. Onto the brassiere, the over-the-shoulder boulder holder, as we always used to call it. Oh, something doesn't hang. It's quite neatly tucked in. I'm not sure. Can I scroll back and see what that says? Oh, I can. Look, I can scroll. How's it hanging, babe? Ah, I got it. How's it hanging? Oh, okay, Shelster. Well, I didn't even know you were doing a live stream last night, so that's a complete fail for me, isn't it? Things are hanging. It's all right, things are hanging, but nobody wants them hanging too much. They just get in the way, you see. So people tell me. Right, now I'd seen this before and ignored it. So I saw it this time and I thought, well, I'll look it up. It looks a bit like a rag. But it's got mohusive. Can you see? Oh, no, you can't see them. You see, I've attached the wrong thing to the wrong thing. In the top of your right sock. Oh, what have I done here? Oh, God. Hang on. I can't even button up a shirt. I mean, that's how bad it is. Have you ever seen buttons so huge? Mohusive buttons. But it's that Lagerlöf thing again. And although it's got a summery vibe, it's embroidered. So there's lots of detailing on it. A bit hard to see in that light, really, isn't it? It's not that bright out there. I think it's just the contrast. There we go. It's all embroidered up. So I thought, okay, this is going to be some brand. Looks very little worn. And this one was Maragibuchi. They do look like coconut shell, actually. They might well be Maragibuchi. And I did a little look, because again, I take my time when I'm in there. And it seems it's one of these Logan Lucky brands that does quite well. And it is 100% linen. And I think it's one of these made in Italy jobs. So a coconut, actually, yeah. Yeah, because look, you look at the back of them and they're all sort of ruffy and like a coconut, like someone's literally taken the coconut and gone whack, right, okay, that'll do as a button. Who thinks of that sort of thing? It's obviously got a holiday vibe about it. But at £2 each, I mean, I try and have a decent profit margin, but you know, I'd be quite happy with £20 for that. I don't know about you lot, but I have been getting some very silly lowball offers lately. I mean, stupid lowball offers, which I've countered with equally not very much reduction. Yeah, I like linen because it's natural and I can wear it, but that whole thing of you not having to mind looking a bit creased up, a bit rumpled, but then I kind of reckon I look a bit rumpled anyway, so it kind of goes with the thing. It goes with the flow. Yeah, trousers, wide leg trousers are doing quite well. These aren't wide leg. They're not wide leg. And I'm not sure if they're ladies or gents. I think they're gents, actually, because it's the way that things go across there, isn't it? But they are Hugo Boss. Hugo Boss. Oh, silly questions. Oh, yes. I've had someone saying to me, I haven't received my parcel yet, ha ha. I thought, well, who puts ha ha on the end of their message for a start? And I've got it down as having been signed for. So plainly said person lives in an apartment. And I said, you might need to check with a neighbour. I said, but if it hasn't turned up, you'll have to go through eBay and open an item not received because it'll have to go through them. But I know I won't lose any money because it's been signed for. So covered. It was a pair of Timberland shoes, so they weren't cheapy things. I have had quite a lot of returns lately. I'm not sure if it's the weather, people being incapable. And I have one item not as described. Now, get this. It was one of these... I'm doing this on my shoulders because it's one of these things that you... like a stole, but it's, you know, it's like one of those sort of just fur wrap ones. Not a huge one, but one that's a bit like an oversized collar. It was an accessorised one. It was one that someone gave to me, actually. I didn't go out and buy it. It's so soft and lovely. Sent it to this woman. Well, obviously, I photographed it on my Edna mannequin thing. And, you know, she's a size 8 to 10. I've just kind of draped it around her. And then this, but I have put the measurements of how long it is and I have put the measurements of how wide it is in the condition report and the description because I just copy one from the other so they can't miss it. And she said, it's not as described, it's tiny. I'm a size 12 and there's no way it looks like that on me. She's actually sent a picture with it sort of draped around her shoulders, but it doesn't look much different. But... so I had to send her a return envelope, but I hate getting not as described. Edna, oh, she's got no Ed. No Ed Edna. We do get silly questions attached to things though. Oh, now this. There's a lot of this. I don't know if it would fit me, but there is a lot of it. Actually, it might. Well, probably not width-wise, but maybe height-wise. And that is saying something. Ski wear, I have started selling. I would definitely recommend picking up ski wear. This is a mad colour, and it is called Tenson Air Push. It's a little bit vintage, because the colours are vintage, aren't they? I mean, we all know. And it's a big, big, long, very long ski suit. In fact, if I didn't know better, I would say that would fit me. So it's a grown-up size, but width-wise, probably, I don't know, probably not me. Oh, what's that? Oh, the belt. Comes with a belt for me to lose as well. It's very kind of early 90s, late 80s. Lots of pockets, which I will check. But these actually go for pretty good money. Will this dress fit my 36DD breasts? I don't know, love. Do you want me to come round and check? Yeah, stupid questions. things like a kind of like a size 8 dress. Oh, can I see this on? I said, not unless you want to see it on my leg. There's no way I'm going to fit. Oh, it's so tempting, isn't it? Because you will. I know you will. You'll find out where they live. You'll go around with your tape measure and your cold hands on a wet day in Wales and sort them out. Oh, dear. Yes. So that took up more room than anything, really. But those, certainly vintage ski wear, does well, but a whole all-in-one like that, I think it's going to be quite handsome. Now, that didn't cost me £2, it cost me £4, because it didn't have a price on it, which is annoying, because the lady that I go in there, she knows if I'm going to buy something, it's actually worth some money, so, but never mind, I reckon there's probably a good 40 quid in that. You do have very cold hands. Okay. No one wants cold hands in that sort of area. On a completely different note, oh, this will appeal. This isn't one for me. Look, it's absolutely tiny, but I have found, and I suppose it's not that bizarre, but there is a bit of a market for lingerie, particularly if you, as I was saying before, the Spanx. I think I don't know if I showed this fact, the Spanx, but I sold those within literally a couple of days, and not for cheap money either. And they were used. I mean, you know, they weren't brand new. I'm not sure I would have done. I picked this up because I thought it was quite nice. I mean, it wasn't an Anne Summers job. Sorry, Anne Summers, but, you know, it's nicely made. Hello. Steve, just for you. There you go. There we go. I haven't got my nought covers yet, so I'll go for that. I don't think I'd get a leg in this either, actually. Because it's a small, and I'm anything but. I've got to look up the brand, Sophie B. Now, I know a couple of the undie brands, but I don't really recognise that. Sophie B. Or you say made by Matalan or something stupid like that. Let's have a look. I can't see. It has spandex in it. But, you know, those sort of things. There's a lot of people who are quite cheeky like this sort of things. So there might be a couple of quid in it. Carla! Hello! Welcome one and all. I have to say, as I have both the legend that is Lex and the wondrous Carla Jenkins in the chat, I feel quite privileged. And I have to say, what a hoot. All your live streams, your the games. Yeah, it was absolutely brilliant. I've sitting there. Obviously, I'm sitting there in the living room. Husband's watching something tedious on television. I've got an earpiece in and I'm pissing myself laughing. And you can't explain to somebody else. You can't explain to somebody else. Yes, you're very sensible, Carla. Bye. No, hang on. There's more in it. Oh, yes. Now, this was this was actually on the floor. Always goes to put, when you find empty hangers, always pays to have a look. Bollocks. This is more cashmere. This is lovely. And it was actually on the floor in the church. It was underneath. I thought it's always pays to have a little look. Just see if there's anything nice that's got left on the floor. Now, having said that, it's got holes in. Bollocks. What I didn't see. There you are, you can see one there. It's got a couple of holes. Probably because it was on the floor. Bugger. It looked like a nice brand as well. Christopher Fisher. 100% cashmere. I might try an effective. No. This is going to go for making things. But there's lots of cashmere in it. I could try and mend, but it's got to look really good. I might try and mend it. And yeah, if it doesn't look any good, then I'll do it for crafts. I always sell them for crafts. I don't even know, I get a tenner out of it. I have found Brora. Only the once, actually, cashmere. I have found other things. That was because I wasn't looking. I was just like, oh, no more cashmere. Got a bit excited in the shop. Brora cashmere is absolutely bloody lovely. It's gorgeous. It feels better than there's cashmere. And there's cashmere. And that was fabulous. And it sold very quickly, surprisingly. Ah, here we go. Right. I thought this looked really boring. It's in that sort of taupe, not very well dog poo kind of colour. But it's phase eight. I don't pick up a great deal of phase eight, but I thought this was suitably Logan looky big of the time of year. These kind of jumpers, particularly the ones with a roll neck or this kind of cowly neck thing. Oh, that's not brilliant either. That's got a thinning thing that I can mend. Things like that I don't mind. This is one of these enormous sail-like puka colour things that people like. It's wool blend, but it's got the Logan look thing about it. So I thought, yeah, we'll grab that and some bread and butter there. I've been selling a few jumpers and things lately. Cashmere is goat. The fruit of the cashmere tree. Oh, that's quite an odd image, isn't it? The fruit of the cashmere tree. There must be an awful lot of little goats around the world, though. Yes. Oh, quite the fountain of knowledge today, Carla. Well done. Saving me the bother of trying to remember. What is all that, then? It's like, does it feel nice or does it not feel nice? That's kind of my thing. Oh, now, I was quite chuffed to find these, she says, trying to make sure the zip works first. Yes, it does. North Face. Occasionally I find North Face and then there's always something wrong with it. I couldn't find anything wrong with these. They're just those sort of hiking pants, trouser things, but they've got the zip off your legs. Oh, and yes, I have a problem about Angora. Whatever it was that Steve said. Okay. What was it, Steve? Yeah, so this is the North Face. I mean, it didn't really stand out, the logo there. But I go through things quite carefully because they price everything the same. They really don't stick a price on because something's got a nice label on it. Oh, don't. My son was addicted to Bugs Bunny. Still watches it from time to time. It was almost on a loop at one time. Oh, my father, who almost fell asleep. Oh, we're boring him with our superior knowledge of clothes and cashmere and other such lovely things. Going to the bottom of the bag now. Hang on, where are we? Right. Okay, people, last three items. Oh, right. Steve's about to receive a photo. Cashmere's one of those things that finding it without holes in is tricky, and it tends to go in sort of clumps. Someone will give a... Why have I gone out of focus? Hello? There we are. Maybe out of focus is actually better. Do I have a problem with Angora? Well, personally, I couldn't wear it because it drove me nuts with the itchiness. But also, I think there's been a thing around about how they get the Angora in that the bunny wabbits suffer. Let's put it that way. I'll leave it at that. I don't want to go into gory details, but suffering of rabbits is involved. Did someone just say... Now, I'm sure you've copied and pasted that because I couldn't type all that out without making hideous spelling mistakes. Yes, and here it is. Boho. Corduroy. Fabric of the moment. Slightly military look. Yes, we're nearly there. If you're interested, look it up. It's not something that people necessarily are interested in. These are the buggeringly awful join it together things. Yes, I had a shirt like this and it drove me nuts. I've got a thread that's come loose there, but I can sort them out. But these are nice, these little jackets, and people like them for evenings. Yeah, if I see Angora and I'll sell it on, but I'm not over keen. Wow, Nick. Hello. Is that Nick or is that Andrea? I'm assuming that's probably Nick. Hello. I've practically done a haul. Yeah, no, it really offends me, I think. There's no need for it, really. I'm sure the rabbits would quite happily be brushed and give up their fur that way, but I think such is the demand for their fur. I've got a huge pile of clothes here, it's going to go. I think they sometimes remove it without permission. Now, the last two things I've got here. Oh, excuse me. Well, actually, no, I've got something else to show, if anyone's interested. Yes, I kind of had lunch before I started. I do well with this brand and no one ever recognises it. Keep your eyes peeled, ladies. That looks like someone's just squiggled randomly, but it actually says Gudrun Stjoden. Anyway, however it's pronounced, Gudrun Stjoden, It's one of the, that is the original Lagerloch brand. Yeah. And I've got two of them. Sorry. Nearly did a little happy dance in the shop because this stuff makes stupid money. Really stupid money. This is a lovely, well, lovely to those who like that sort of thing with a little button up front, top sort of boiled wool kind of cardigan thingy. Oh, and it's actually rather sweetly. Although, why on the inside where no one can see it? Seems to have a random, what is that? Oh, random chicken. It's that way. I was thinking, what is that? It's like, no, that's its bum. And that's its top. So it has a random chicken there. Nicholas, ladies should not claim trees. Really? Well, I'm not a lady, so that's pretty easily sorted. Still £2. Yes, they should if they can. Ladies shouldn't fall out of trees, yes. Totally agree. So that's rather nice. I'm assuming that's wool and it's going to need a bit of a debobble. Ah, here we go. Internal label. Gudrun Schoden. 100% wool. With a spare button. So all I know is it depends on the style, but I sold a jumper like this about 18 months ago because I don't find it very often. I really missed something in the chat there, haven't I? That hurts. There's the topic. And then I found another one. So plainly, someone's donated a great huge jobbit of it. This is one of these. This is quite a cool design for those who like this sort of thing. Very autumny. It's a very thick. God knows what's going on there. It's a large. It's her again. It was £2. It's short sleeved, but it's kind of like a tunic-y sort of thing. There we go. Yeah. Florals, not really me. But there we go. It hasn't got pockets. Oh, it has got pockets. She's quite famous for having pockets and everything. Fighting to... Oh, God, no. We're not having a fight, are we? So that's like a tunic, and it's in a very thick cotton, I think. In that sort of funky design, 100% bum wool, which means bum wool. Cotton. Pew Villa. God, the funny things they call Bumble and Pooville. I'm not lying. It says, you know, Pooville. What's in its pockets is indeedy. Yeah. So those two things on their own made my trip this morning worthwhile. Loose thread. Get rid of that. But the cashmere, the jackets, the ski suit most definitely, and the other bits and bobs, I think that's... Oh, and an added bonus, they're giving me one of these enormous, enormous, enormous bags, which will be very handy for storing my jumpers in and coats in down the shed. We love a pocket, don't we? So that's it on the clothes front. But I do have a couple of things I didn't share last time because I'd forgotten I've got it. I bought a little baggie. I paid £1.50 for my little baggie. I actually bought this the other day in a different shop. But, you know, they've just started doing little bags of jewellery and things. And I even suggested to one other shop, because I know the lady in there who runs it, and she's terribly sweet and everything. I just said, and they always have bits of jewellery under a really scratched counter, as you can see, bugger all. And I never think to look because I've got my arms full of stuff by then. And I said, oh, have you ever thought of doing, you know, sort of like bagging stuff up in a jewellery bag and kind of selling it as a lot? You've got too much or it's tangled or you just can't bother to go through it. She goes, oh, we've got loads of jewellery. I'm thinking, I said, well, it might be an idea. So I know a couple of other shops have done it and it might help you just get rid of some of, if you've got a backlog and you want to shift it, that might be a good way to do it. Saves you price doing it all individually. Yes, I would. So I'm kind of going paying them a visit later in the week and see if they take me up on their idea. So for £1.50, I got... These aren't real pearls. Oh, it's Nick. Hello, Nick. Yeah, I'm kind of stocking up on jewellery, and although I'm really bad at listing it, it's almost like I'm hiding it away so that if I'm ill or I can't get stock, I've always got something to go back to. Sorry, someone's reversing outside my window. This is definitely vintage because it's one of these pull, and it's got a little... That's it. Isn't that what people do? A little bead on it. So that's a definite vintage class because I've learned from Lex the lobster claws and the modern ones. Can't get it back in now. There we go. So they're just vintage ones. They're not actually pearls. And these are vintage, and they're not actually pearls. I have found pearls in charity. Oh, hang on, have I done this right? Here we go, trying to show you properly. There we go. It's a pearl necklace with a very unusual clasp, which you press down. I can't remember. Oh, you pull it. There, sort of a clasp like that. It's very unusual. And it has a safety chain that made me think, oh, that's half decent quality. I suppose it would kind of be sort of choker. I don't wear choker style. But, you know, I don't quite know where to begin, but I'm sort of stockpiling it and thinking, well, one day. And this was all in a £1.50 bag. Probably. I think it's 50s. It's certainly two. It's not 60s. It's quite old. These ones have gone, which is a shame. I suppose you must be used to finding them a little bit like this, where they get very... It's not the worst. Thank you, Carla. That's very sweet. These have got sort of yellowy. They are all faux, but they're nicely made, knotted in between. But they go yellow, and I think I worked out why, because when the lady's wearing these, and then she puts perfume on, and I think it's the perfume that does it. So this also had a nice little bejeweled clasp, one of these hook, little hook jobbies, which I think the clasp is sometimes better than the necklace, but there we are, single strand. Yeah. Oh, yes. There has to be a pearl necklace, doesn't there? Sippy, sippy, bang, bang. It makes me giggle every time I see one, to be honest. I've just got that sort of a mind. I can ask you more. Steve's been very well behaved, thank you. This is what attracted me to it initially, because this is just mad. Very statement. Now, probably that's the back of it. Is it the back of it? I don't know if it has a back or a front. There we go, if I do that with it. Sort of very tribally. These are stones. It's not plastic. They're cold. It has little, they're not dream catchers, but it has these little, it's not silver or anything. But I just thought that was really cool. That grabbed her. Yeah, you see, Lex and I do share a similar taste in mad jewellery on a metal chain. So that's very, yeah, makes a nice noise. It could be a chandelier in a doll's house. Yes. Would never have thought of it that way. Most definitely. I like it. It looks like some kind of agate or something. I'm quite up on stones, but I'm just not very good on jewellery per se. But I thought that was amazingly weird. And this all out of a £1.50 bag. I mean, honestly. Now, I'm surprised I haven't gone up in flames for simply touching this. We know what one of those are. Anyone from a Catholic background? It'd be a rosary. It's not a good one, no expensive one. It's really rather worn. It's sort of copper kind of chap on a cross there. Yeah, so, you know. Yeah, it's not really my taste, but, you know, somebody's believing me to take more than 10 Hail Marys to sort me out. yeah, and then the final thing in the bag. Do you? Well, this one can come over your way if you would like, because it's certainly of not very much interest to me. And this I thought was so lovely. It's kind of a very... It's the colour of it. Oh, dear, you've got Nia, not the thing. Hang on, let me try and do this professionally, like so. Here we go. Again, these are stone. They're cold to the touch, and they're obviously little chips of things, but I don't think they're garnets. They're slightly too purpley, but they look more brighter on the camera than they do in real life. But I just, you know, I love real stones. And that was a £1.50 bag, so I thought, I went back there today, which is where I got this lot from, and they still had the same bags they'd had there from previously. It's like watching QVC. Yes, I should have been a hand model. Yeah, I think when I was younger, someone told me, did say, I should be a hand model, and I was quite insulted. But hand models make good money. I just kind of thought, so what's wrong with the rest of me? I had that kind of attitude then. Yeah, so I've, like I say, if you want it, Lex, yes, it's here. It's here and put away, and I haven't gone up in flames for it. I'd like to clear my, yeah, that little shop near me out of jewellery. I'm going to sort of cultivate them, but I was kind of pleased with that. But But I do find some very strange oddments. It's just things I don't know enough about. Some stuff's just horrible. I also got some guide badges as well. Gave another lot. Little guide badges for things. Guides. I expect Andrew will know a little bit about these. They're very modern ones. I mean, I remember the old-fashioned ones. That's quite a modern one too. There we go, guides. But there's bound to be someone out there that probably wants or has lost theirs and wants to collect them. That doesn't show up very well, does it? No. Oh, and a pack leader one. Pack leader, I think I actually looked that up. So I might job lot those. And then I've just got some nasty beads. So I'll end up with a job lot, really. Actually, I wouldn't know what they are. I did look them up, to be honest. But yeah, that's kind of me lot, really, apart from me mad jug. I was showing at the beginning. It hasn't got a signature. It was something about it that grabbed my interest. So that'll end up sitting on my research shelf, which is the equivalent of Colin, who's on holiday. Not so in close at the moment because she's away. Her granny shelf, but I have a to be researched pottery shelf. So there we go. Was that when you opened them all? You opened them all one after another. You had a great video with just going through all these things and you made hundreds of it. That's absolutely brilliant. Now, that would be telling me. I haven't really had time to sit down and read it properly. I thumbed through and thought there were a good few things that I might. But, you know, I think it's like when other people get a recipe book and you kind of read it and go, it's a lovely read. And then you think, yeah, what am I actually going to cook from it? Do I have the right ingredients? Is that what I need and want right now? And it's pretty much the same as a spell book. It's kind of there for inspiration, to give you different ways of doing things, perhaps. And then you kind of think, well, I like that, but I'll change it round and I'll do it my own way. But it's more for inspiration than I tend not to follow any recipe in 100%, which is why I'm not a baker, obviously. I tend to follow things fairly loosely and I'm pretty much the same in my magical work. So. But it works. It works. I'm very much into poppet making at the moment. A very good friend of mine wrote a book about it, about making little dolls. And it's all for where you pop little, where you put your wishes and intentions into it and then you enchant the doll. And it's about good things, not bad things. Oh, yep, that one is also, hang on, I backtracked there. Ingredient. Well, yes, you see, I mean, my store cupboard of witchy things is a store cupboard in the same way that your kitchen cupboard is a store cupboard for things you will use in cooking. So, although it's an awful lot stranger and much more of a surprise when someone opens it not knowing what it is. That's funny. Someone goes, oh, I was just looking for some placemats. Oh, what's that? Some very large sword appears. So, okay, it's just the sword. Put that broomstick back where you found it. Candles. Four candles. Actually, sometimes more than four candles. And preferably ones of different colours. yeah, Lex and Carla were doing their four candles routine the other day, which is hilarious. yes. Yeah. Sword. Yes. A samurai sword. Wow. Okay. Is that sharp? No, well, obviously they're sharp in a sense, but yeah, no, I have what I call a coven sword, which is sort of for general use and people to use as part of the whole thing. And then I actually have my own personal sword. I'm quite good with. No, I don't do things against people. They're to help. They're for help and mind focus and being in the right space and good things. There are a number of people I'd be very tempted to, try and do something with, but I wouldn't, because if you do something, how can I put this? I did run a coven for quite a number of years, and at the moment I'm not. It's something to do with having a 12-year-old son. It kind of makes it very difficult to work from home. So currently we're not. I have my own sword. Yes, there's a lot of things that you will hear said in kind of Wiccan pagan circles that really Yeah, you just think if this was heard in the Muggle world, it would cause great consternation and possibly an arrest. yeah, people have their athames, their little swords, daggers, I suppose. They're never meant for use in the practical mundane world. They are for magical purposes only. And then you'll have a berline, which is for cutting herbs and things like that. And then a sword for casting circles and bigger things like that. None of it's desperately secret in that way. It is all out there. But it's like mine have got little cat heads on them. They're made from very ancient. They're very ancient. Oh, bless you, Steve. No, for good purposes only. Oh, dear. Yeah. We have to warn those trolls, won't we? Some of those trolls, be very careful. Be very careful indeed. Oh, dear. And the problem is I could chunter on about witchcraft for ages, but there's probably certain things I'm not supposed to say. But there's a lot to talk about. What about the ones in front of you? Yes, indeed, Sibby. Well, look, it's been really lovely chatting to you. I know you've probably all... Oh, I've got some listing to do, photography, while we still have daylight. A lady I know, she has a pet crow. I love crows. I don't have a pet crow, although we have some that nest out in the back. but yes, I'm very fond of crows. Very much indeed. And it is true. Yes, you do have to think very carefully what you're intending to do and all the potentials. They say be careful what you wish for. It just might happen. And there are things, it's like anything, things have consequences. No, I would not actually turn them into trolls. I don't think I need to. I think something in their brain is plainly amiss. I would wish them that they find something far more interesting to do and are happy and fulfilled doing something else other than hanging around on YouTube channels that are of no relevance to them. Send them on their way. Yeah. I think the love and the light thing, you do try and work that way, but there are occasions when maybe... Because I have heard people say to me, are you a black witch or a white witch? Or no, they usually say white witch. And I say, well, I'm just a witch, really. I try and do the right thing. If I get it wrong, I try not to. Very, very strange. So I say, oh, I'm just a witch. I'm not any particular colour. And nothing's ever completely black and white either. Sometimes there are grey areas and there are ethics around magical work, just as there are ethics in others. Indeed, Enoch, yes. And there is what we call the threefold law of return, which is whatever you put out there, you're going to get it back three times over. So it's a good idea to make sure it's good stuff. Indeed, Lisa. Yes, absolutely. Yes, I think people just feel a bit safer. They kind of think, oh, well, not too scary because she's a white witch. Voodoo lady from Monkey Island, live and let die. Well, you know, there are certain caricatures and we play up to them sometimes, but generally... Witches look like anybody else. You wouldn't necessarily know. Some people are more overt about it and like to advertise, but not everyone. Yes, party on, dudes. I've got to let you work because I've been chuntering on for 3/4 of an hour. So it's been lovely chatting to you. I'm pleased with my haul. I hope you guys find good stuff too out there. And I hope that eBay just settles the fuck down. Because... we all need to enjoy Q4 because we've been looking forward to this for some time. So I hope it all goes well for you. So happy times. Bye-bye.